American Towman Magazine, first on the scene for the towing industry since 1977.
Recovery Roundup, brought to you by OMG Tow Marketing.
Hi, I'm Emily Oz for Tow Industry Week. It's another edition of Recovery Roundup, where we feature towing's power players take on heavy-duty jobs with expertise.
It's a puzzling scene of a double fatal car crash where the owner of a Porsche Boxster going at terrific speeds loses control, launches into the air, and crashes through a second-story office building. Accurate Towing Service of Toms River, New Jersey joined forces with authorities on scene right away and quickly determined the structural integrity of the building itself was jeopardized, leaving a dangerous situation for recovery crews. We hear from Accurate owner Tom McCooch, who was on scene with their custom mix of Miller and Jerdan products, a 50-ton Jerdan rotator on a Kenworth, and a 25-ton Century Wrecker on a Peterbilt.
When I got there, I pulled up, and I kind of walked around to the front of the building, and it looked like a building that a bomb went off in the top floor. It was a huge hole in it. The corner of the building was missing. The side wall, the whole front of that room was just gone. And you could see the color red from the car. And I had walked up to one of the emergency guys, and I asked who was in charge, and the chief of Toms River was there along with the fire and rescue chiefs. You know, we have to devise a plan of action at this point. I said, what kind of car is that? They're like, we don't know if it's a Ferrari or a Porsche. You know, they had just gotten on scene. The car is so mangled, it was, it's incredible, actually. You'll see from the pictures. So at that point, I said, what's going to be the game plan? Let me know, what you want us to do, what kind of assistance we can provide at this point. They said, well, we wanted you on scene because we really want to know what you're going to need for us for you to be able to take that car out of the building. I said, okay. They're like, you want to go up and survey the situation? I said, yeah, but it turns out that the bodies of the people were still hanging upside down in the vehicle when we got there. They hadn't removed them. They were trying to do toxicology. They were trying to do all their preliminary surveying. We got up to the floor where the car was, and it was just an unbelievable scene. Not to be gory, but I've never seen this much blood in any accident I've ever been on. And it was a hardwood floor, and it was gallons of blood. We tried to put absorbent down on top of it, because blood's a biohazard, you know? So that's one situation right there. It's like, all right, the risk is very high in this job. All of a sudden the news media just started pulling up the cameras, NBC, ABC, they were coming down from New York, Philadelphia, and it immediately became like a really high profile thing. We're up there looking around, and all of a sudden the left corner of the roof started like falling. So it was at that point deemed that the structure, the building, was completely unsafe, especially with the weight of a vehicle up top floor. You know, if it broke loose, it would just cascade downwards. The building would just completely collapse. So we suggested that we build some sub walls kind of behind the car to help the structure integrity. They started in a basement. The fire department, the rescue team were great. They called in a couple other teams from other towns. I believe it was Bricktown, Toms River, Silverton, and started building walls from the basement to the first floor, to the second floor, to the roof, to add some strength to the structure of the building so it just didn't completely collapse, because it was under tremendous pressure from the car and the damage to the building, because a corner was completely wiped out of the building, and that is weight bearing.
After getting approval of their recovery action plan from authorities, Tom says what came next felt like a defining moment in his career.
At that point, he said, fire and rescue, everybody evacuate the building now. Anyone that doesn't work for Accurate Towing Service, evacuate the building now. So that moment was a very defining moment in my life.
The car came out of the building without any issues.
Using the radio to communicate to Alex, and he did a great job operating the wrecker. I would have him boom in, winch up, boom up just a little bit, let the left winch out, pull on the right winch. We ended up breaking the car free from the wall, boomed in a couple times, used the underreach to put a little pressure on the car to help guide it out, you know, so it didn't like slam against the truck. You know, obviously with that kind of coverage, you don't want any kind of quick moves or any jerks or any, you know, you don't want anything negative to happen, you know? So you got to be cautious. You got to be fluid. And yeah, it just turned out great. We winched in a couple of times, winched up, boomed in several times, adjusted the cables, let the car hang straight, pushed pressure on the back of the car with the underreach, lowered it down. Then I had him move the truck forward 10 foot. Once he moved the truck forward 10 foot, we took I had him take the winches, straighten the car out, level it out, and set it down on the sidewalk on its roof. Once we set it down on its roof, we disconnected the cables off the car, took the rigging out from the sub chassis and the engine cradles, and the investigators wanted to take pictures of the bottom of the car. We ended up using some grade 100 half-inch chains. The car was so destroyed, it was just tough to find spots to rig to, but I did find in the back at the engine cradle, there are two spots right by the engine where the body bolts go to the engine cradle. I ended up wrapping the chains around the holes by the engine cradle and choking them up real tight to the bottom of the engine. Then in front, we had to remove the little, they've got a plastic plate that covers the whole bottom suspension of the car. And it covers a fuel tank also. So we ended up removing that and fishing the chains through the suspension where it goes, bolts to the body, which is a very strong point for the car.
Thanks, Tom. Please consider submitting your recovery to be featured on the Roundup. Visit recoveryroundup.com. Thanks for watching.